Hello and welcome, brothers and sisters in Christ, to this next installment of our preparation for the great feast of Pentecost. Today we're going to read through the third reading from the Old Testament for the vigil of Pentecost. And this reading is taken from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The hand of the Lord came upon me, and he led me out in the spirit of the Lord, and set me in the center of the plain, which was now filled with bones. He made me walk among the bones in every direction, so that I saw how many they were on the surface of the plain, how dry they were. He asked me, "Son of man, can these bones come to life?" I answered, "Lord God, you alone know that." Then he said to me, "Prophesy over these bones and say to them, 'Dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God to these bones, see, I will bring spirit into you, that you may come to life. I will put sinews upon you, make flesh grow over you, cover you with skin, and put spirit in you, so that you may come to life and know that I am the Lord.' I, Ezekiel, prophesied as I had been told, and even as I was prophesying, I heard a noise. It was a rattling as the bones came together, bone joining bone. I saw the sinews and the flesh come upon them, and the skin cover them, but there was no spirit in them. Then the Lord said to me, 'Prophesy to the spirit, prophesy, son of man, and say to the spirit, thus says the Lord God, from the four winds come, O spirit, and breathe into these slain, that they may come to life.' I prophesied as he told me, and the spirit came into them. They came alive and stood upright, a vast army. Then he said to me, 'Son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel. They have been saying, our bones are dried up, our hope is lost, and we are cut off. Therefore prophesy and say to them, thus says the Lord God, O my people, I will open your graves and have you rise from them and bring you back to the land of Israel. Then you shall know that I am the Lord when I open your graves and have you rise from them, O my people. I will put my spirit in you, that you may live, and I will settle you upon your land. Thus you shall know that I am the Lord. I have promised, and I will do it, says the Lord." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And we pardon the interruption of that insect flying there into my ear. One of the ways that we address the Holy Spirit in the creed, which we profess every Sunday, is we say, "I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life." The Holy Spirit is the giver of life. And this prophecy from the book of the prophet Ezekiel especially speaks of the Holy Spirit in that way, as the giver of life. The Spirit who comes from the four winds and lifts up the dry bones now covered again with flesh by the Lord and giving life to them. This prophecy speaks of many things. It speaks of the return of the people of Israel who were in exile in Babylon during Ezekiel's time, centuries before the birth of the Lord Jesus. It's a prophecy about the resurrection of the Lord Jesus himself, the true temple, the joining of God and man together on the third day after his passion and death, and thus giving us hope. And this prophecy also speaks of our hope that the Lord will give us life, not just as he gave us life through our first parents, Adam and Eve, in the beginning when he breathed into the nostrils of Adam the breath of life, but that he will give us and has given us eternal life through our rebirth in the Holy Spirit, beginning at our baptism. We're here today in our cemetery, right out back of our church parish. And it's in a fitting place to speak about the Holy Spirit as the Lord, the giver of life. This cemetery, like every Christian cemetery, is especially a sign of hope in the resurrection. We lay the bones of our beloved departed in the earth, and we let them sleep, watching and keeping vigil. We know that they already see God face to face for their particular judgment, but we wait with them, as we do for all people, for the last day, when the Lord will raise us bodily in the final resurrection of the dead. And through the Holy Spirit, our hope is that we will share in Jesus' resurrection to eternal life, because in our baptism, by the Holy Spirit, we have been incorporated into His one body, the church, of which Jesus Christ is the head. Now, this resurrection, this giving of life, yes, it refers to our baptism, it refers to the last day and the resurrection of the dead, but it also has a daily, everyday relevance to us as well. For example, in the sacrament of confession, when our soul dies an eternal death through mortal sin, the sacrament of confession breathes that resurrected life back into our soul so that we begin to live again in the life of grace. And what better way to prepare for Pentecost, brothers and sisters, than to come to confession? We have confession every day in the Kiesler Center parking lot in the mornings, Monday through Saturday, 9:30 a.m., and again on Tuesdays in the evening from 6 to 7:30, and Saturday afternoons from 3:30 to 4:30. And it also, brothers and sisters, I think speaks to our daily experience of the life of prayer. Oftentimes, I believe, we are afraid of going to the Lord in prayer, and so we find any excuse, any distraction not to. And we're afraid because in our heart of hearts, we feel like our soul, our heart, is something like a graveyard, a place where we say with Ezekiel, how dry it is, how hopeless it seems. Can the Lord actually speak to this place of great pain, this unasked question that I carry in my heart? And the word of the Lord, brothers and sisters, is yes. Yes. If we will, in daily prayer, go to that place in our hearts, the place where we might fear to go, the place that seems dry or dark or hopeless, that is where the Lord will breathe new life into us by the Holy Spirit. So be encouraged, brothers and sisters. Be of good hope. The Lord breathes His Spirit into us and gives us life every day of our lives when we turn to Him in prayer. Let's close with the prayer that follows this reading for the vigil of Pentecost. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. O God, who have brought us to rebirth by the word of life, pour out upon us your Holy Spirit, that walking in oneness of faith, we may attain in our flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.